पेपर वन क्वेश्चन नंबर 13. इन दिस देर आर टू ग्लास रॉड्स हैविंग आइडेंटिकल रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर आर गिवन. द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेसेस फॉर द मटीरियल ऑफ दीज रॉड्स इज गिवन आउट टू बी म्यू इज इक्वल टू 1.5 एंड हियर म्यू इज इक्वल टू 1.5. The separation between these two rods is given out to be D, and it is given that a point source of light is placed inside a rod S1, inside the rod S1 on its axis at a distance of 50 centimeters from the curved surface. That means the point is located at a distance of 50 centimeters from this surface towards left because it is inside the rod. And we have to find the separation between D under the condition that the light rays coming from it are found to be parallel to the axis inside S2. That means once the light rays goes inside this medium, this rod, they become parallel to the axis of the rod. So let's take this as the first surface and this as the second surface. And for first surface, we'll write 1 by V minus 1.5 divided by minus 50 is equal to 1 minus 1.5, and their radii are given to be 10 centimeter each. Both the surfaces have 10 centimeter radius. So this is minus 10. From here we will get V to be equal to 50 centimeter. Now this image will serve as an object for the second surface. So if we write the equation for second surface, we'll write 1.5 divided over infinity because the rays are becoming parallel to the axis of the rod, minus 1 upon minus d minus 50. If the image due to first refraction is getting formed here, somewhere here, and this separation is D, that means distance of the object for this rod will be D minus 50 from the second surface. And this is equal to 1.5, that is the refractive index of this, minus 1 divided by 10. So D minus 50 will be equal to 20. So D is equal to 70 centimeter. So the correct option is B. Paper 1, question number 14. In this, a conductor given like this is carrying a current I. This part has got length L, this has got length L, this radius is given out to be R, and this one is given out to be R. And then we have to place the system in a constant magnetic field in different directions as given in the options, and we have to find the relation between force and the length of this segment. As we know that force is equal to I L cross B, where L is displacement vector of the wire, that is, it is the shortest distance between the initial starting of the wire and the end of the wire. And we know that this expression is valid only when B is uniform. Now we know that this segment from here to here has got a length vector which is given by 2L plus 2R I cap. So F will be equal to I into 2L plus 2R, I cap and cross B. Now we can check when B is along Z cap, that is Z axis, then I cross K, it will here it will be I cross K and the force will be proportional to 2L plus R, that is proportional to L plus R. If B is along X axis, then force will become equal to 0. If B is along Y axis, then again the force will be proportional to L plus R. And if B is along Z axis, the last option, it is given that force will be 0, which is not the correct case. So, considering this, the correct option is A, B and C.